रागादि रोगान् सततानुसक्तान् अशेषकायः प्रसृतान् शेषान् औत्सुक्य मोहारतिजान जंगान यो पूर्व वैद्याय नमोस्तु तस्मै यो पूर्व वैद्याय नमोस्तु तस्मै यो पूर्व वैद्याय नमोस्तु तस्मै। गुड इवनिंग फ्रेंड्स, I welcome you all on the third day of this 83rd online pulse diagnosis program. This program is conducted under the banner of Nirog Street as and gesture to felicitate the winners of the competition and the quiz. Last 2 days we have seen the historical background of the Nadi Pariksha. Yesterday we have seen the anatomy and physiological concepts behind the Nadi Pariksha, and I asked you all to do certain homework just to feel the pulsation along your arm, part one, and part two was to keep your three fingers on the pulse and examine them throughout the day for at least 50 times. This can help you to understand the natural variation which can happen in pulse diagnosis. Pulse reading is a very normal and natural phenomenon. Every time and anybody who has his tactile perceptions intact, when he keeps his fingers on the pulse, he gets the pulsation. Only problem is, we might not be able to know the algorithm behind it and how to analyze it. The first part of this 6-day program is about knowing the pulse, and the second part, which we'll do it on 5th day, would be understanding the pulse. This is a stepwise learning program. You have to go step by step. It is not possible to directly jump to a diagnostic phenomena like the questions I was getting, how to diagnose Vata Pitta Kapha, whether which hand to be used. There are multiple phenomena attached to pulse diagnosis. Today we'll be examining at least 2 or 3 levels of the pulse out of the 5 levels which I preach. There are multiple methods of pulse diagnosis. As I've told you, there are 4 dominant ways of examination of the pulse in Indian subcontinent, all based on the same principles. Adi, Madhya and Antar. Adi, Madhya and Antar. Now, this Adi, Madhya and Antya is interpreted in multiple ways. Somebody thinks Adi is Tarjani, Madhya is Madhyama, and Antya is Anamika. Some people think there are 3 parts of each finger, Adi, Madhya and Antya, Adi, Madhya and Antya, Adi, Madhya and Antya. So 3 into 3, 9 parts are examined. Certain people think in another way, Adi, Madhya and Anta, and then from back to front to back, Adi, Madhya and Anta. That makes every fingertip is divided into 9, and then pulse is examined. when you are examining with this particular method, you are examining at one level, only one level. But the method which I preach has 5 levels, and it has different meaning of those 5 levels of the 3 fingers in each level. So 3 fingers are examined, the touch under 3 fingers are examined, but then the meaning at each level is different. So at the end, what you get are the 5 pictures of analysis. You are finding 5 levels and then 3 fingers. What are those findings at the 3 fingers? And these 3 finger findings at 5 levels are brought together and arranged as a jigsaw puzzle. Jigsaw puzzle, you might have been aware of. You must have played jigsaw puzzle sometime in the past as a child, or sometime probably your children might be playing. There are 5 different pictures. Pictures are broken up into various pieces. You have to organize those pieces in such a way that picture becomes complete and accurately complete. The same phenomena is used here. We get 5 different broken pictures. We have to organize those 5 pieces together to make a diagnosis. So you cannot make diagnosis by one level, that's for sure. If you try to make one level and diagnose, you are going to make a mistake. Every level has very different meaning attached to all the 3 fingers. So remember this. If you are aware about some other kind of pulse diagnosis, forget it. For next 3 days, another 3 days, you just forget it. Try to learn this particular method. Try to understand how to achieve those 5 levels, and then how to end up with the diagnosis with that 5 levels. Saying so, let us come to the place where we are going to examine the pulse. Yesterday I told you how to identify the location of the pulse. So you have to follow the same method. Keep your hand like this. If it is you are examining your own pulse, this is the best way. If you are examining somebody else's pulse, then you can always ask them to sit beside you, keep their hand on the table. If the patient is putting their right hand, you have to use your right hand. If the patient is putting his left hand, you have to use the left hand for examining the pulse. You have to sit, make the patient to sit on your left side. So with this, what you have to do now? How many of you have checked your own pulse yesterday for 50 times? Anybody? Please say yes in the chat. So was it same all the time? That's another question. If you have seen it for, somebody said 20 times, somebody said yes only. So it was all the same for 20 times, or it was different in all those 20 times? Or sometime it was same and sometime it was different. Remember, you must understand this. The pulse represents the dosha pattern in the body. And doshas are ever-changing forces. They are energy forms. So ultimately, those changes are visible in the pulse. So now, you have to see what to check in this first level. The first level is the moment you identify the location of the pulse. Keep your index finger first, then middle finger, and then ring finger. When you put this all three fingers together, you have to make two things very clear. The pressure you are using it on the index finger, the same pressure must be carried out on the three fingers. You cannot change the pressure under each finger. So the pressure you have used to identify the pulsation under your index finger, the same pressure must be used for the middle finger and for the ring finger. So making it sure that all the three fingertips are going to be in one plane. You can practice this by a simple technique. Always try to feel your pain, and that will automatically make it all your three fingers in one plane. You can just do this. This is a practice. Everybody must have it. Right? So the questions, I will take it at the end. So those who have any questions, they can put it in the chat or in the question box. Because with the given period of time, but we have limited period of time. Normally my discourse goes for seven and a half hours. So we are going to talk within 4.5 hours. So if we spend more time on answering your queries, it will be difficult. So I'll answer all the queries at the end. We'll finish up at least 2 or 3 levels by 7:35, and 7:35 to 7:45 we'll have question answers. All those questions which are there in the chat or in question answer box, I will answer them all. I have another webinar at 8 o'clock. So we'll have to fix up and finish it up by 7:45. So every question you have will be answered. So the first thing first, make sure that you are putting the same pressure as you are putting with index finger. Identify with index finger alone. Don't put your three fingers in searching the pulse. Number one. Number two. Just keep your three fingers on the pulse. Are you by any chance filling the tube, which is called nadi, or you are only filling the pulsations? Your finding will be you will only be feeling pulsations. If you feel a rope-like thing under your fingertips, it can only be possible if your artery is thickened and diagnosis is very clear. It's a case of severe atherosclerosis. And you can easily tell them that your triglycerides are above 350 and your cholesterol is more than 250. Pulse, a rope-like pulse. Normally what we feel under the fingertip is only the pulsation. Check it out, because that is where the diagnosis starts. Normally we feel, we understand that way, that we feel the pulse as entirety. No. What we feel are the only the pulsations, the expansions happening within that arterial system. And that expansion is felt like a wave, because it's a bolus which expands the artery. So when it expands, the expansion varies in different ways. But when it expands and then collapses, so it makes it a wave. That makes it a wave. And when we talk it as a wave, so every wave has one part which is going up. There is another part which is on the top, and then the third part which is going down. Feel it under your pulse. If you can feel these three parts, then the entire pulse diagnosis becomes very easy. Keep your eyes closed, keep your fingers on the pulse, and try to feel the upgoing part of the pulsation, the upper part of the pulsation, and going down of the pulsation. Of course, this entire phenomena happens in less than 0.2 seconds. So don't expect the way I am telling you. If you calculate this, this is more than 3 seconds. It will happen 4 times within this period. So you have to be very cautious, attentive to feel the pulse. That is why Shodashkal Bhishaja says, a good vaidya need to be dakshe. He should be alert, aware. And then just keep your fingers and feel how the pulsation is happening. So first thing, what you can feel it in the pulse is the morphology. How that pulse really is felt. You can check it out. There are two possibilities. Either you can feel the pulse like this. Can you feel the pulse like this? Or sometime you may feel that it is going up and rapidly coming down. One is, it is going up and then moving up and coming down, giving some kind of placement on the top. But in the next, you can feel it that it is going and coming down. If you want to feel it in more easier way, you can feel it as this part of your pain. How it is? And we'll feel that particular softness is happening when it is rounded one. Or otherwise, it can happen this way. You can touch your fingertip with this. The pain, open up the pain and touch the nib of the pain with your fingertip, where the pulse is rising up and coming down. That is called as pricking pulse. The rising up and immediately coming down. There is no top on the thing. So first part is anachronic and then immediately diachronic. That is called pricking pulse. The other way it is anachronic, top, and then diachronic. So it is a soft pulse. A soft pulse indicate physiological condition, while the pricking pulse indicate pathological condition. Something is wrong, not in the right way going on in the body of the person who is sitting in front of you. That is the first thing what you have to feel when you are keeping your fingers, all the three fingers, in same plane at the place where you have identified the pulsation with your index finger. Don't bother how much pulse pressure you are giving. You have to feel the same pressure. You have to put the same pressure that you are putting it on your index finger. That's all. That is only one requirement. Your all three fingers should be in one plane. That's the second requirement. This practice of keeping your three fingers in the same plane is a must. Otherwise, normally your fingers are like this. They are never in the same plane. They are at different planes. But this is a special practice you have to develop to make your three fingers on the tips. You have to use only the tips. Don't use this flat surface. Don't ever use this flat surface. Use only the tips. And when you are using the tips, you can easily place them at 90 degrees to the arm you are examining. So that together makes it very simple and easy to access the pulse. You can watch me once again. See what I am doing. I am using the tip and it is 90 degrees to my arm. All my three fingers are in the same plane. Can you see this? Not a single finger is going down. And then I am feeling it. The first thing I am feeling is whether it is pricking or whether it is soft. In physiological condition, the requirement of the body is nutrition. And it makes it that plasma moves on the periphery within the artery. The cellular part becomes in the central movement. So that's why it is felt soft. But when there is a pathological condition, inflammatory condition, trauma, immediately the defense system comes on the top. Then the flow becomes plasma centric. And that plasma centric flow makes it cell on the top and it becomes pricking. The expansion alters. And you can easily identify the pricking and the soft pulse. Soft pulse indicate physiological condition, while pricking pulse indicate pathological condition. Now, we move to the second part of it. We have to keep the fingers on the same place. Don't move your fingers. Don't press, don't loosen them. You don't have to relax, release, or don't have to press more. On the same place, we have to identify six things. In the same place, we have to identify the six things. And this area is known as immediate expression or the first level of the pulse or the cross understanding of the pulse. It is the first level of the pulse or the gross understanding of the pulse or immediate level. Those who are well conversant with my videos or my books, they will know these terms. These are known as immediate expression or the first level in the pulse. It gives you the gross information. The first information you got is whether the person is in the physiological condition or in the pathological condition. Second, which is very common and every single doctor measures it, whether your pulsations are happening regularly or there are some misbeats or some extra beats. So whether it is regular or whether it is irregular is the second part which has to be measured. The first part is whether it is regular. Regular is the time gap between the two pulsations needed to be the same. Of course, there is a small hitch into it. As technology developed and we started to analyze the plethysmographs or the cardiograms with AI based machine learning programs and the digital ECGs have come in existence. So analysis become very, very competitive. And then we found that there is a variation in two consecutive pulse that is called as heart rate variability. That is called as heart rate variability or HRV. This heart rate variability forms the basis of the entire pulse diagnosis program anywhere in the world. Those trained fingers of the ancient physicians could identify the variabilities without the help of machine learning or artificial intelligence, and they could judge it the smallest possible changes. But for normal human eyes, it is impossible. If you remember, we have discussed about ECG yesterday, a common ECG pattern. And this is taken on the graph of 1 mm squares and at the speed of 25 millimeter per second. 25 millimeter per second. So one cardiac cycle is completed into 20 small squares. For normal human eye, it is very impossible. I'm not using the word difficult. It is very impossible to identify heart rate variability unless there is a gross variability. And that is arrhythmia. That is arrhythmia, not HRP. For with ECG at the speed of 25 millimeter per second, you cannot identify HRV. But with the expert mind, and expert is how the expertise comes, you can only become expert if you practice it regularly. If you don't practice, you cannot become expert in any damn thing in the world, not even in pulse diagnosis. Listening to me is not going to make you expert. But what I'm preaching, what I'm telling you, if you practice, will definitely make you expert in shorter time. For me, it took a long time. For you, it will be very short, because I'm giving you the crux of every single phenomenon. So when you are putting it, the second item on the list is whether it is regular or irregular. If it is irregular, if you find multiple misbeats and or otherwise multiple extra beats, you have to check the pulse for 20 consecutive pulsations for that. If you examine 20 consecutive pulsations, you will be definitely able to identify the irregularity or regularity of the pulse. And if you find the pulse irregular, it indicates involvement of cardiovascular system. Only if the pulse is irregular, it tells you that something is wrong with the cardiovascular system in the person whose pulse you are examining. Second. Third thing, what you have to feel, because as I've told you earlier, you don't feel the pulse as such, the tube as such. What you feel is the expansion, the pulsation. Dhvan, the dhvana dhamanya. So only dhvan we can feel. Thup, 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 thup. Now you have to be little more cautious. If you can recall your experiences, past experiences of drinking some cold drink, jaise aapne lassi piya ho, गन्ने का जूस पिया हो, कोल्ड ड्रिंक्स पिए हो, जिसको हम स्ट्रॉ से पीते हैं, ध्यान में रखें, ये रिजेम्बलेंस है स्ट्रॉ के साथ. तो जब हम जब तक उसको पीते नहीं है ना, स्ट्रॉ से पीना है, तो आप स्ट्रॉ ग्लास में डालकर या बॉटल में डालकर, हवा में बॉटल पकड़कर नहीं पी सकते, आपको स्ट्रॉ को पकड़ना पड़ता है. और आपको एक चीज़ बड़ी महसूस होती है वहाँ पर, जब आप खींचना शुरू करते हो तो स्ट्रॉ की कंसिस्टेंसी में बदलाव आता है. जब तक आप खींच नहीं रहे हो तब तक वो स्ट्रॉ आपको खाली खाली से महसूस होती है, और जैसे ही आपने खींचना शुरू किया तो वो जो फ्लो ऊपर आएगा तो आपको एक फीलिंग देगा कि वो भरी भरी सी है. नाड़ी में भी आपको ये दो फील मिलते हैं, एक खाली खाली सी नाड़ी और एक भरी भरी सी नाड़ी. अब ये भरी भरी सी नाड़ी हो या खाली खाली सी नाड़ी हो, आपको एक चीज़ ध्यान में रखना बहुत ज़रूरी है. हमारा कार्डियोवास्कुलर सिस्टम जो है वो एक क्लोज सिस्टम है, वो एम्प्टी कभी नहीं होता. अगर आपको एम्प्टी नाड़ी मिली पूरी टोटल खाली, तो वो बड़ा डेंजरस साइन होगा, और वो उसका लक्षण होगा जहाँ पर ब्लीड हो गया है भयंकर मात्रा में, आपके शरीर से खून ज़्यादा निकल गया, तो आपको डेफिनेटली नाड़ी में एम्प्टीनेस नज़र आएगा. पर यहाँ पर जब मैं एम्प्टीनेस की बात करता हूँ, दैट एम्प्टीनेस इज द एक्सपेंशन ऑफ द आर्टरी. व्हेन द पल्स इज एक्सपांडिंग, दैट एक्सपांड्स विद द फुल ब्लड इनसाइड, और देर इज सम लैक्यूनी इनसाइड. इफ यू फील दैट एम्प्टीनेस, इट सजेस्ट the chronicity of the condition, and if it is full, it is the acuteness of the condition. छह में से तीन चीजें हो गई. नाड़ी हमारी कैसी है, वो सॉफ्ट जा रही है या प्रिकिंग है. सॉफ्ट है तो फिजियोलॉजिकल, प्रिकिंग है तो पैथोलॉजिकल. वो रेगुलर है या इरेगुलर है. इरेगुलर है तो वो हमें इन्वॉल्वमेंट ऑफ कार्डियोवास्कुलर सिस्टम बताती है. तीसरी चीज़ हम देखते हैं, नाड़ी फुल है या एम्प्टी. अगर फुल है तो एक्यूट है, और एम्प्टी है तो क्रॉनिक है. ये तीन चीज़ें. चौथी चीज़, जैसे हम चाय या कॉफ़ी पीते हैं तो वो गर्म है या ठंडी है ये देखने के लिए अंदर उंगली नहीं डालते. अब जो कप में है उस कप को पकड़कर हमको अंदाजा आ जाता है वो गर्म है या ठंडी है. वैसे ही जब हम नाड़ी पे उंगली रखेंगे, नाड़ी तो सब क्यूट है, स्किन के अंदर ही रहने वाली है. अगर नाड़ी पे उंगली रखने पे हमें वार्मनेस नज़र आती है हमारे फिंगर्स पर. कल मैंने आपको तीन एक्सपेरिमेंट करने के लिए कहा था. एक ये मार्किंग, दूसरा अलग तरीके के फ्लूइड्स और ड्रग्स दवा सामान को फिंगर्स में या ट्यूब्स में या स्ट्रॉ में भरकर उसको सील कर उसके फीलिंग का वेरिएशन लेना. ये वेरिएशन इसी चीज़ के लिए है. मैंने आपको तीसरी चीज़ और एक कही थी, छोटे वाले पेपर कप्स जो आते हैं जिसमें आजकल कटिंग चाय मिलती है, उन कप्स में अलग अलग टेम्परेचर का कोई भी आइटम भरिए, चाय भरिए, पानी भरिए, और उसको फील करने की कोशिश करिए, तो आपको टेम्परेचर वेरिएशन ध्यान में आएगा. ठंडी का मतलब आइस कोल्ड कभी नहीं होती. आइस कोल्ड पल्स इंडिकेट करती है मर गया. स्ट्रेट, जैसे किसी मरे हुए आदमी को आपने देखा होगा कभी, उसके पल्स पर उंगली रखते ही आपको महसूस होता है कि ही इज नो मोर. पल्सेशन नहीं है, बिल्कुल जीरो पल्सेशन, कोई मूवमेंट ही नहीं है, बिल्कुल ऐसा लगता है कि जस्ट गया. दो नंबर पे वो ठंडी जगह लगती है. तो ठंडी पल्स नहीं लगती कभी, या तो वार्म लगती है या नॉट वार्म लगती है. सो ये वार्मनेस है जो आपके आपके फिंगर से अधिक वार्मनेस आपको फील करती है, तो वो इंडिकेट करती है कि वहाँ आम की स्थिति है. आम आप सब जानते हैं, उष्मलो अल्प बलत्वेन धातु माध्यम अपाचितम दुष्टम आम प्रचक्षते. वाग्भट की बड़ी सिंपल सी व्याख्या है, उष्मलो अल्प बलत्वेन, यानी जब आम की स्थिति मिलती है हमको तब हमें वहाँ पर सीधी सी इंफॉर्मेशन मिलती है कि यह अग्निमान्द्य की स्थिति है. उष्मनो अल्प बलत में काय अग्नि की कमी की अवस्था के कारण से आम निर्मित होती है. जब नाड़ी में हमें उष्णता मिलती है तो वो हमें आम की स्थिति बताती है. अब रही बात, ये चारों चीज़ें जो है ना, हमें तीन उंगली में कहीं भी मिली तो उसको अस्तित्व तो हा करना है. वो एक फिंगर पर मिले, दो पे मिले या तीनों पे मिले, पर अगले दो जो हिस्से हैं वो आपको इंडिविजुअली हर एक फिंगर पर देखना है. पहला हिस्सा है ये तीन में से आपको कौन से फिंगर पर पल्सेशन मिलता है, या तो इंडेक्स पे मिलेगा या मिडल पे मिलेगा या रिंग पे मिलेगा या कोई भी दो पे मिलेगा या तीनों पे मिलेगा. ऑल थिंग्स आर पॉसिबल, इंडेक्स, मिडल या रिंग, तर्जनी, मध्यमा, अनामिका. So you have to identify under which fingers you are getting the pulsation. Some of you have said that they got only on two places. Some of you said that there is a variation, a bit of variation. Some said more different. This will, somebody said that there is a, it changes after the meals. Then you had multiple meals since yesterday evening. So every meal the changes were same or not, you will definitely feel it differently. So you have to do is under which finger you are finding the pulsation, either it is index, middle or ring. यहाँ पर index का मतलब है नाभि के नीचे का हिस्सा, नाभि के नीचे का हिस्सा. Middle का मतलब है नाभि और हृदय के बीच वाला हिस्सा. और रिंग का मतलब है हृदय से ऊपर वाला हिस्सा, क्लियर, नाभि के नीचे, हृदय और नाभि के बीच में और हृदय से ऊपर। ऑफ कोर्स ये जैसे ही मैं आपसे कहता हूँ आपको वाग्भट का अगला श्लोक याद ही आएगा, वायु पित्तम कफस चेति त्रयो दोषा समासतः ते व्यापिनो अपि रुग्णाभ्यो अधो मध्य ऊर्ध्वश्रय। पर प्लीज इसे वात पित्त कफ नहीं कहिएगा, यहाँ पर ये शरीर का निचला हिस्सा है, बीच वाला हिस्सा है और ऊपर वाला हिस्सा है। और ये बीच और ऊपर के लिए हमारे पास डिमार्केशन जो है वो है नाभि और हृदय। इसके बीच वाला हिस्सा जो है वो मिडिल फिंगर पे दर्शाता है, नाभि के नीचे वाला हिस्सा इंडेक्स फिंगर पर और रिंग फिंगर में हमें हृदय के ऊपर वाला हिस्सा मिलता है। तीन चीज़ें यहाँ पर जो इंटेंसिटी है उसको काउंट करना भी ज़रूरी है, क्योंकि ये इंटेंसिटी हमें बताती है वहाँ पर जो कार्य हो रहा है उसकी तीव्रता कितनी है। और इंटेंसिटी आप अलग अलग लेवल पर गिन सकते हैं, कुछ लोग हैं जो 1 to 100 या 1 to 1000 के स्केल पे, 0 to 1, 0 to 100 या 0 to 1000 के स्केल पे, कुछ लोग हैं 0 to 10 के स्केल पे, कुछ लोग परसेंटेज में गिनेंगे। मैंने एक छोटा सा ग्रेडेशन डिज़ाइन किया है जो आसान है, क्योंकि हम आसान नाड़ी परीक्षा सीख रहे हैं, दिस इज एन ईजी पल्स डायग्नोसिस, सो ग्रेडेशन आल्सो हैज़ टू बी वेरी इजी। सो आई हैव क्रिएटेड अ ग्रेडेशन, 4 ग्रेड ग्रेडेशन सिस्टम। द फर्स्ट 0, 0 इज नो पल्सेशन, इफ यू डोंट फाइंड पल्सेशन अंडर फिंगर यू कैन राइट डाउन दैट इंडेक्स फिंगर 0। इफ यू फाइंड वीक पल्सेशन इट इज 1+, if you find moderate pulsation it is 2+, and if you find strong pulsation it is 3+. So you have to identify that 0, 1, 1+, 2+ or 3+ under your index finger, 0, 1+, 2+ or 3+ under your middle finger, 0, 1+, 2+ or 3+ under your ring finger. This is what is known as immediate expression or gross expression. The intensity is directly proportionate to the intensity of the activity happening in that point. So it is 237, 637, and we let us go to the question answers. Okay, what are the questions? Well, we are not diagnosing the pulse with right hand and left hand. It is, if you are examining the pulse of the other person, if the person is sitting on your right side, you have to use the right hand. If the person is sitting on the left side, you have to use the left hand. That only is possible because your index has to go towards the thumb. And this position makes it easier. Otherwise, it will become very difficult for you. Vatas Pitta Jan Kafaj Nadi, kyun puchte ho bhai? Main aapko jaise hi samay aayega bata dunga. अभी तो पहले आप नाड़ी में जो मैंने 6 पॉइंट्स बताए हैं उनको आइडेंटिफाई करने की कोशिश करो। डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनेट टू द एक्टिविटी हैपनिंग इन दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम इन योर बॉडी। नाउ देयर इज क्वेश्चन आंसर्स। What are the questions? I could not attend 2 classes. How can you know the nadi is ever changing according to dosha avastha? So you have to listen, go search with, talk to Nirog Street people if they can give you the YouTube or the Facebook where it has been live available, and if it is there you can see those. The rest of the question is irrelevant. Should we check nadi ideally? Of course, we have to check nadi ideally only. What else? And what is other time? Nadi can be checked any time in the day. Index finger indicate vatas, middle finger indicate pittas, and ring finger indicate kafas. I have not said so. So I don't know. If somebody else is saying so, you can definitely follow him. But if you are following my technique, in the immediate level, index finger indicates the lower part of the body, middle finger indicates the middle part of the body, and ring finger indicates the upper part of the body. So the anonymous person is asking, relation between dosha and nadi. first you identify the nadi, then automatically the relation will come to you. Whether are you aware about dosha? And if you are aware, I have told you to put it on the chat, but none of you have done that. So I understand that you don't have the understanding of the dosha. My request to you all, please, please go to my YouTube channel and listen to 1 hour lecture on the concept of three doshas. Coldness on the fingertip, not on the fingertip, it's non-warm on the, in the pulse, it is not on the fingertip. The warmness is felt in the pulse, of course, it is felt on your fingertips. So if you feel warmness, it indicates ama. If it is not warm, it says the ama is not involved. Simple. Anything else? What are the other questions? What are the other questions Shiva is asking? We'll give you the answer of the male right hand and the female left hand pearls afterwards on the day 5. Elaborate, we don't have time. I can just enlist the points. Pricking or soft, number 1. Second, regular or irregular. Third, full or empty. Fifth, when third is full or empty. Fourth is warm or not warm. Fifth is under which finger you are finding the pulsation. And sixth is the intensity under each pulsation. So if the recording is available on YouTube, you can definitely listen to it. Empty or full is the third point. Emptiness, if you feel, it is the chronic condition. If you find it full, it is acute condition. Why same questions are been asked? Huh? I have never said that it is to be examined in the daytime. Every time is fine. We are all physicians. We have to examine the patients whensoever they come to you. You have to feel regularity and irregularity. If the pulsations are felt under continuous and regular intervals on your fingertip, that is called regular pulse. And if the pulsations, you are feeling a misbeat, a beat is missing, instead of coming it regularly, or if you are having some extra pulsation, like this is regular pulsation. This is irregular pulsation. अभी तो नाड़ी देखना तो सीखो, फिर बाद में कौन से हाथ का देखने का वो देखेंगे. सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट चीज है नाड़ी को फील करना. Somebody is asking me what to, can you repeat? Repeat needs another class. Those who want to feel the emptiness and fullness can try a glass of lassi with a small, not the thick straw, but the plastic straws, which are easy malleable. So that can be done. We have spoken about this, Bharti, which other nadis can be checked. Yesterday when we talk about anatomy, we spoke about the hriday. There are three parts of the body: lower part below nabhi, upper part above hriday, middle part between the hriday and nabhi. Sixth point is intensity. You are going to feel it at different fingertips at different time. Nothing, no, it's a natural, normal pulsation. Intensity is not speed. So you have to feel the strength of the pulse. You are talking about in a minute, It is only thing which is measured is the speed. 90%, 90 degree angle is yes. It is very essential because it gives you a correct angle to feel the pulse. That is what the experience is all about. It is chronic condition, is empty. So you have to, that is why it is the clarity, what you say, is the intensity of the pulsation. If you feel weak pulsation, it won't be that clear. If it is a strong pulsation, 3+, it will be very clear. No, you are not supposed to praise the pulse. You have to praise the pulse at the same level you have used at your index finger. This is such a fantastic question you have. Why diarrhea has a feeble pulse? If you are dehydrated, what else will happen? Aapka pulse middle finger mein mil raha hai, to uska abhi intensity check karo, kitna intensity hai. I think this Shiva's questions answer I have already given. Don't get into that trap of Vayu Pittam Kapha Sheti Trayodosha Samasata. Hey Vyapino, remember the Vyapino word first. Vyapino Api Runna Bhyo Adho Madhya Urdhva Sanshraya. These are the things, but don't hear in this particular pulse diagnosis. These are the locations of the pulse, not the doshas. Thank you very much. See you tomorrow. Same time, 7:00 sharp, and requesting all to be on time so you won't miss the things, and make sure that your network is preserved. So if you are not consuming your network for other things in the daytime, you can have the preserved network for this program. Thank you very much. Namaskar. See you tomorrow. If there are any questions, you can type and we'll answer it. Oh, name of my book. It is Pulse Diagnosis in Computer Age. Sometimes pulsation is at the corner of the fingertip. Yes, that is how it happens. And there are multiple ways to understand the pulsations. Doctor, hand of the doctor and patient must be the same, not necessarily. On which side patient sits is more important. Intensity tells you about the strength of the activity, how intense the activity is going on. Thank you very much. All the questions have been answered. So I hope you are all satisfied, and we'll meet tomorrow. If you have questions, please put in the chat and I will be informed. Thank you very much.